Well, howdy, 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 folks. It is glad to be, I'm glad. It's good to be back, and I'm glad to be back in the saddle. Let me get rid of this cat here. Let's see here. You have to bear with me. Look at my crooked freaking hat. I set a box down on it. It's a floppy hat. It moves around. Let me see here. Anyway, I'm back in the office, as you can see. And let me zoom in just a bit. I'm going to change this up a little bit so you're not seeing all my power cords and crap. I want to give you an update, okay? So she wanted to put her big dog cart on a trailer and vend, okay? It kept, she keeps an assistant down here to help, but it keeps people away from her cart when she is at very busy, busy locations. And so she's in Utah, and her inspector said, no, because it's on a trailer, it's considered a food truck, and you, that's a whole different ball of wax, and that's different rules, and you don't qualify for that. So her hot dog cart is a trailer, and because it's on a trailer, so we had a lot of great suggestions from y'all, right? And they were, you know, take the wheels off of it. Well, she moves it too often to do that. And so bottom line is I knew it was BS. And I looked at the code. I read the code. And I decided, you know what? I'm gonna help her out. She's one of the Vendors United members. And I help those folks out. So a lot more, you know. So I called Utah. I did it live right here so you could see it. I called Utah and went through the, you know, chain of command to figure out who to talk to. Found out that different counties in Utah write their own codes, but it turns out the county she's in doesn't write their own code. They use the state codes. State codes don't say anything like that. It's just made up hogwash. It's basically an inspector who is just talking out their butt. And so talked to the inspector supervisor, which y'all got to hear if you heard that video, because I did it live, you know, I broadcast it live. And that, man, that seems dark. Watch this. Booyah. Snap, crackle, pop. Okay. So I was like, okay, this is going to be, convoluted. So that guy, here's what ended up happening. I had to call him two more times. And he kept telling me, well, remember the first time he said, I'm going out of town. Well, he went out of town for like a week. And then he was back and I called him again and he hadn't done anything. So then I called him again, third time, and he goes, oh, yeah, we called the state to get clarification. They didn't need clarification because it was clear. It wasn't convoluted. It's just their interpretation of it was wrong. And he was going to try to defend his employee who was the inspector. Well, it turns out the state saw it how I see it, which is common sense, and they said, it's not a food truck because it's a trailer on a trailer. It's not enclosed. It doesn't have sides. What? So that's the way the state saw it and told this person, the district, the regional, whatever, county manager, the county health department guy tells the other guy. Anyway, bottom line is it's done. She can vend on that trailer anywhere she wants. So when she goes to these busier events and busier locations, she can have it set up so that she's out of the way. Dragon Winners and Catering. Hey, glad you're here. Did you check your email? If you didn't, Amanda, you need to check your email. Sent you an email just a little bit ago, maybe 35, 40 minutes ago. Hey, Owen Lewis in the house. Thanks for being here. Let's see. Oh yeah, you did look at the email. I just got to that comment. All right, good. Awesome. Can't wait to see you take off with it. VU. All right. So here's, yeah, I see your arrow. Okay. Let's see. I want to read some comments real quick and go through these. And then I got to get back to answering phone calls that I missed and emails that I'm behind on. And I apologize if you're one of those people. Let's see. Okay. How much coffee grounds in, this is Ice Cream Lady Driver. She asked how much coffee grounds in the 5 gallon. I don't remember. I'll find out for you. I don't remember. We're talking about cold brewing and I don't remember if it's like two pounds or 1 pound of coffee. I don't remember. I'll find out. Okay. Let's see. I already read that one the other day. This is Boss Colon says, does he grill or boil his brats? If so, how does anyone know if a good pre-cooked brat or hot link? My suggestion for any time you want to know a good brat or sausage or hot dog is do your taste test, because what may be good by my standards, your area may like something different better. Some people like that snap. Some people want a natural casing. Some people like mushy dogs, like my wife and most of our family. They like the chicken pecker and wing dogs, you know. So always do a taste test, then determine which ones hold up best in boiling or steaming, whatever your plan is to do. Okay, I answered Kevin Stevens. I hope you got your message. I answered you a couple days ago on what types of licenses you'll need. I did it in a video. I'm sorry I didn't link the video to your question, but I've been on the road. I got back this morning at 1 a.m. I was up here at 6:30 answering emails. Let's see. I'm running through these fast, so bear with me. That is, a nice cart. I just bought one. I'm going through all the steps to get started. I'm located in Denver, Colorado. Recently been watching your videos. I think I would replace my burners. I'm doing a lot of repairs myself. Food truck shops have be liars. You possibly let me know where I can order new burners for steam table. Depends on the type of burner you need. Now you can always change that out, but typically you can buy a grill and rob the burners out of it. If you just need those long burners, I don't like the long burners. I like individual burners so that I can adjust the temperature better. We sell those on our website, dirt cheap. You go to, hotdogcartstore.com and you'll see those burners. They're just cast iron burners and they hold up better than the stainless steel burners. Stainless steel burners are typically oval, oblong, or circle, but they typically just don't last as long. All in all, that was Joe Fix It. So all in all, Hot Dogs and Catering asks, what day and time do you go live? Day and time that I go live, it's sporadic. And I apologize. Typically for YouTube, 8 o'clock on Mondays, 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time on Mondays. But I go live through the week and that's just whenever. So I don't have a rhyme or reason. I just, if I get good questions or I get questions piling up, I'll try to get to them all at once. Ben, could you please explain how you would store and keep a chili and onions warm in a cart in Florida? Flip and Franks and Catering LLC. I answered that for you the other day. Hope you saw that video. I created a special video just for you while I was driving. And for anybody else that needs to know that information, that is on there as well. Let's go. Teamwork. It's because this is from BWW Irving. It's because some states don't allow people to sell stuff like that by cart, hazardous, blah, blah, blah. Number or Angela, I do them sporadically during the week and weekend. Morgan says, hi, great interview. Is there a place online to find Rick's Dogs now? All the best. Rick's Dogs. Yes, you probably can. Typically, if somebody allows me to put out their company name, or allows me to put their link, I'll put their link in the comments every time but I always ask. Some of them don't want it because then they get flooded with messages. And we had that lady, Jackie, this has been a few years ago, and she got bombarded after the interview. I mean, bombarded. She said, please take the video down. Take my name off of it. I'm getting hammered. And so we did. Her video is still there, but we edited everything down so that they couldn't find her as easy. Let's see. Raymond Perez said, that was Morgan just now. I'm sorry. I didn't start that out with that. Raymond says, you are absolutely right, Ben. This is an opportunity for becoming independent of the ordinary 9-to-5 rut. Absolutely. And your advice is worth thousands of dollars. Thank you for that. I just bought your book and I will study it before I invest in my first hot dog cart. Thank you again, Raymond. Thank you for the kind words. Also here's something Raymond just brought this up or reminded me to bring this up. One, if you want to learn the business and you, I've got the free websites, learnhotdogs.com. But if you want my book, go to, Hot Dog Save My Life, hotdogsavemylife.com, hotdogsavemylife.com. The book, you can get it for about 10 bucks, less than 10 bucks. And, it will show you exactly what I did and how to do it and how to avoid these mistakes. and you can get started making money first week. So without a bunch of mistakes and trial and error and trial by fire, you can avoid all that. And then there's tons more information for you too at learnhotdogs.com. So, but if you have, I'm speaking to those who have my book or a card of mine and wish to do an honest testimonial on video. It needs to be 30 seconds to whatever, 2-3 minutes max, right? An honest testimonial. We're giving away, I'm going to pick a winner. Now, all your videos are up for grabs as far as I may use them. I will use them if they're good. But I'm going to pick someone, and we're giving away money. Not a little bit of money, a lot of bit of money. So it's a total of $1,000, two winners. Okay. So if you're interested in that, I believe it's on the blog at learnhotdogs.com. If it's not, just email me, ben@learnhotdogs.com, ben@learnhotdogs.com. And I can send you the information on how to do that. If you're on my email list, you get it automatically. I've already sent it out. Okay. Anyway, crazy. Okay. Jay Garrison, buddy, you're shoving too many topics in one video. Then you're going to love this one, Jay Garrison, because this one has a lot of topics. It made it hard for me to get the info I was looking for and cheated your channel. You should make one video, one topic. It will make you more money, YouTube money, make you more YouTube money. Okay. One, I don't monetize. I am a YouTube partner, have been for years. I choose not to monetize. Monetize is just click a button and they'll put ads in your videos and you make money from it. I choose not to do that because I hate ads. And if I was going to have ads, like just like the one I just did on a book, I'll put my own ad in. There you go. So don't really care about the YouTube money, but I appreciate the comment and I agree. I agree with you that it should be topical. It's hard for me to stay topical though sometimes because during a topic, I take live comments. I take those live comments and I answer them. Well, now I just added more topics. So it's hard to do it. But I do try to stay topical or at least have a topic for it. You will find though, if you go to learnhotdogs.com and you just type in the search box in the top right, type in the word that you're searching for, a keyword, you will find that I have topical content there and videos on anything you could want to know about street food vending at all. Lemonade vending, donuts, you name it, I got it. Okay? But Jay Garrison, I appreciate it, and I don't take offense to it at all. I think it's a good point, okay? I probably could do it if I just did more videos in a day, you know? If I stopped the video as soon as I got questions and went and did you know, the five videos for each of the, or a video for each of the comments, basically, of questions. It's just a little tougher to do that way. Anyway, Stephen C., anyone from Cleveland to know anything about getting a started in Cleveland? I've called and they give me different situations. From what I was told, we just need a business license and vendor's license. Then we have to contact the city to see what spaces are available because it's some sort of pay to play in Cleveland downtown. For outside city, you need a council person to approve your cart for the city. If so, they can work in a public parking spaces. When I check the website for my license, it says I need an outdoor restaurant permit, $50, and a surety bond, $35 application fee, and then $1,000 for the bond. I don't know why your bond would be $1,000. That would mean they want $100,000 in insurance, which if you get the $299 insurance that we always pitch, it ain't our insurance, but if you get that, it comes with lost payee, which is better than a bond, and it's $2 million of a lost payee coverage. So that's what I would do there. I wouldn't do the $1,000 bond. That seems ridiculous. If anyone knows the real and exact process, I would greatly appreciate the assistance. Stephen C., I give you step-by-step what to do there. On the blog, learnhotdogs.com. You're basically asking for everything to get started there. We have vendors in Cleveland. And so, yes, you can do this. We know it can be done. Do I know them off the top of my head? No, I do not know the exact step you would need specific to these questions. But I will tell you this, it's probably not that bad. And you probably need to go or call, take a name when you call, and ask specific questions. Hey, I have a hot dog cart. I want to vend. Where can I vend? On public property? And then is there any permitting license requirements of vending on private property? And go from that. Now, Boss Colin says, does he boil his brats and sausages? I think I just, Oh, that's another question. It's a great question. Okay. So he's talking about, I believe he's talking about Frankenstein's that I filmed live a few weeks ago. And I'll be filming him again, I think this weekend at a Harley event, Harley Davidson event. So here, does he boil his brats or sausages and then throw them on the grill? Yes and no. He steams a lot of his stuff. He boils some stuff. Typically brats you steam. Some people boil them. I do. But you can, it depends on what you're doing and what kind of brat it is. Some don't hold up good to boiling. Some don't hold up good to steaming. They need to be grilled, period, or they need to be dry heated. And then, you know, like on a grill, like a charcoal grill or something, or a gas grill, or a griddle. So I show you in that video, him pulling the dogs out. You'll see what he's doing there. He's steaming. Okay. And he's steaming everything. And then he's throwing on the grill. So he's not boiling anything there. I don't remember him boiling anything there. Yeah, he wasn't. On that day, he wasn't. Okay, Drag Geeks, I have found a perfect spot in front of an Ace Hardware store. Those are good spots. It is outside of their property. I don't have to ask them for any permission. I only have to go to the city and get permission from them to be on the side of the street. It's going to be next to see what the city says to me on what and what's your thoughts. My thoughts is that's great. Ask the town, you know, the city on public property, because you're on public property, which is partly your property, right? It's all of our property. And so find out if they allow it. If they don't, you're going to have to talk to Ace or find another private property owner. But I think those are great spots. Now I know a vendor and I've actually taken pictures of his setup before because I tried to help him and he's still in business as of the other day. I saw him again. And he has no signs. He just kind of wings it and he's in front of an Ace, but he's on, another piece of private property across the street, but it's a side street from Ace's parking lot. And that's, he's drawing traffic from Ace that way. But it, he's the only Ace one that I know, you know, Ace Hardware that doesn't do that well. He's tickle pink if he makes $100, $150 in a day. Most vendors after doing this a little while, they want more than that. I'm not saying that's bad money. I'm just saying most of us wanted, you know, we're like, okay, I'm gonna be out here for 3 hours. Took me, and you know, it's gonna take me an hour to clean up. It took me 30 minutes or an hour to prep and to arrive and set up. So I've got 5 hours invested into my 3 hour day. I want more than $100, right? So, that's typically how that is. Drag Geeks, thanks for the question. Let us know, keep us up to date. And I appreciate those that do ask me questions, then we answer them and then you keep us up to date on your progress. And I hope you enjoyed that. Let me go to and see if I have any questions over here. Have you ever talked about a good practice if you have to use the restroom and you're only one running the cart or stand? I have a lot, Scott. But let me tell you this real quick and where this would be if you were going to go look for this. Okay. If you had to go look for this information, learn hot dogs and just put in bathroom in the search box. But let me go ahead and answer this because this is the quickest, shortest answer. Did you hear my previous answer just now? How long did I say you're out there vending typically? 2 to 3 hours. My factory gig, it's 11 to 1. Tuesdays and Thursdays, 11 to 1. That's it. I typically know my bowel symptom, you know, bowel movements. I know if I don't drink 2 gallons of sweet tea or Diet Pepsi before I arrive, I'm going to be pretty good to go. I'm not going to need to use the bathroom. there are those occasions where, oh crap, man, that Hardee's biscuit hit me hard this morning and now my stomach's hurting. And yes, I've had to stop the cart and go find a bathroom. I even asked a customer one time to watch my cart while I went into a tire shop that I was in front of to use their restroom. So it can happen. But typically you're out there working and you don't need a bathroom break every 30 minutes or every hour or every 2 hours. So, and if you're only working 2 to 3 hours, you should be fine. It's a non-problem. And until it is, you see what I'm saying? I vended for a long time. And then that whole time I had to use the bathroom twice while I was vending. And that includes vending some long events, like 6 and 8 hour events. Then it becomes more of a problem, you know, as far as then you would have help though, if you're doing events, because if you're not, if you're at an event, you're there because you're busy or you plan to be. So you should have people there too, helping you. I hope that makes sense, Scott, but that's a good question. And it's one a lot of people don't think of until it's, you know, later that they need to use the bathroom and they're like, crap, that would have been a good question to find out. So I'm glad you asked. Frankensteins, I think I might be figuring out this YouTube thing. Awesome, Frankensteins. I was just talking about you. My 75-year-old lady friend just bought a cart from you. So happy. Thanks, James Bobbitt. That is cool. Eric Von Dumb, hey, Ben, got my book today, 5 days delivery. Glad to hear it. He's talking about the hot dog cart saved my life, or hot dog saved my life. I said cart. Hot dog saved my life is the name of the book. It's a course. It's not like a storybook, although I sprinkle in a little of my, you know, personal experience in it on occasion through it. But that's it. Dragon Winners and Catering is going to be rocking soon. Congratulations to you, Frankensteins, BMW. Frankensteins, I plan on starting up once I retire out of the military there in Sanford, North Carolina. Hey, Scott, I will come see you when you do. Okay. Start and boil, move to grill, turn off boil to hold so they don't shrivel, grill and then back to steam and fold down and serve. Booyah. How's that for an answer on how he's doing the dogs? Right there. Frankenstein says, hit me up if you need help. Frankenstein helps a lot of vendors answering questions, and especially in the Vendors United site. He posts up videos. If you're vending or about to, go ahead and join Vendors United. LearnHotDogs.com/join. LearnHotDogs.com/join. I'm going to put it right here. LearnHotDogs.com/join. And you can become a member. It's cheap. Okay. It's dirt cheap. And you get to have access to Frankensteins and many others who kick butt and do good and help each other out every single freaking day. Vendors are posting up videos or maybe have a question or a problem or they found something cool. There's so much to gain. Eric Von Dumb, what a great community. Everybody helping everybody. Can't wait to join. You're going to love it, Eric. It is a good community. But don't join until you need to. We have some vendors in there like Amanda. She's here right now. She hasn't started yet. She's fixing to. Okay. She's fixing to. But she's been in there for a while. Amanda, how long have you been in there? You've been helping other vendors because you have restaurant experience and management experience and military experience. But you've also asked questions. Like you've been learning at getting ready and you found out stuff. So she joined in October. So there you go. So it's almost June, right? And she's been in there. That's 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, something like that. I can't count. I'd have to pull off a shoe and that, you know. Anyway, so there's a big value in it. There's a lot of people in there that haven't started yet or about to start. So Dragon Winner's been researching since July 2017. See, that's doing your due diligence. That means when Dragon Winner starts, she will hit the road running, not at a slow pace, not a learning curve. Boom. She already got her catering. She's legal to cater already. She's got all her ducks lined up. Lizzie's Colorado Dogs, and I love that name every time, and Sammy's, we joined 2 months ago and just started vending last Saturday. See, that's the kind of thing. You learn a lot, and you can ask the people that are in there. And if you want more, go to our Facebook page and just ask people on the Facebook hot dog page. The one that there's 33,000 people on there. You can surely get, not all of those are members, obviously. Okay. But you can ask and put the members will post up and tell you. But thank you, Lizzie's Colorado Dogs and Sammy's, and thank you, Amanda, Dragon Wieners and Catering. Thank y'all. I hope you have a fantastic day. I'm going to get my butt busy answering emails and voicemails and WhatsApp messages that I've missed. I love you. Hope you have a great day. Talk to you soon. I'll be back soon.